Here in Davos, it's time to shed the suits, pile on the protective gear, and get ready to do real battle. They call it hockey diplomacy.
This is diplomacy. I got everybody covered.
We'll do the ice. 10 minutes, 20 minutes, we're done.
Here we go. Here we go.
Over the last 5 years, the world economy seemed to be skating on thin ice, but with the recovery on a firmer footing these days, the world's top brass can let their hair down a little bit and enjoy some of the winter sports that are on offer in Davos. For instance, ice hockey. After all, you can't solve all the world's problems in the boardroom, can you? Instead of profits, tonight it's all about passing the puck. As for net income, well, it's just this net that counts. A refreshing change for these uber-successful men. Among the blue jerseys, we've got telecoms billionaires from places like Canada and also Russia. We've got the deputy prime minister of that own country, as well as the president of the Republic of Tatarstan.
I think a good break from all sessions and meetings that we have in Davos.
Sports is a great way to bring people together, and Davos is really about bringing people together.
You work in the oil and gas sector, right? You met any interesting people during this match today?
Yeah, we met a lot of people tonight. It was a great game.
The match is over. Nobody won, as it turns out. The game was tied. I must say, it's absolutely freezing, and that's the reason why the referee has decided to call it a day. What kind of match was it?
It was chilly, very chilly. But the friendship, the camaraderie, and certainly the aspect of playing the game is what kept it warm out here in Davos.
Who knows what kind of hot deals might be struck after this night on the ice. Nina Dos Santos, CNN, Davos.